This is Dr. Aroke Hilary, who was a librarian in 1981. They are the pioneers who started grammar school. Well, at that time, it was known as GSS, Fontaine Grammar School. And today, you have received an award. Dr. Aroke, I just want to ask you, how do you feel receiving this kind of academic award?
Well, coming here today to support the launching of the Almanac, I never thought I was coming here to get any award at all. And so it was a big surprise to me that I was called for this particular award. The bad work that I did as a young child in government secondary school Fontaine when the school opened was first offered. So I really appreciate what the 8995 has done, recognizing the work that we did in the school in trying to promote the name of government secondary school Fontaine Marie.
Yes, I know you have been very consistent when it comes to education. You are very persistent in the way you volunteer, you donate. You are appearing in debates through Gaza Media. You are appearing in different platforms, educating the public. I mean, you have that passion. And what last word do you want to say to young children as a mentor to copy your footsteps?
Well, the only thing I would like to say is that education is a lifelong learning process, and that you are never too young or too old to learn, and that there is always something new to learn tomorrow. And even as an adult, I continue to learn, and I encourage everyone, especially those who are now in the United States, to return to school and acquire degrees to move up in the academic ladder and also in their professional endeavor.
Yes, thank you so much for coming out, and you have done a lot. I would think this is not even enough to reward you. It's just a token for recognition. So we really appreciate you coming out to support the 9 bars today.
Thank you for this opportunity to talk to Gaza Media.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I think many of you will have known this face before, but if you don't know, he was the senior prophet at one point in time. And his name was Fuataku Denis. And he used to write the name of student to punishment. But at that time, people thought punishing he was hatred. I think you were not being hatred, but you were just providing discipline. Looking at your discipline and what you contributed to the growth of that institution as a whole, what can you be proud of today?
I think, thank you for talking to me. I think I should be very proud of myself first for taking that responsibility to ensure that people were able to follow the footsteps of our elders. You know, our generation was almost, I think we are almost the third batch of grammar school, I'm not quite sure. But we follow the footsteps of our brothers and sisters. And we were able to discipline some of you guys the same as we were disciplined. So I think that we went a long way to ensure that grammar school was kept intact. Every aspect of the school was intact, and I'm so proud of that and the development that has taken place up to today.
Yes, I know some young one looking at you today, how successful you are. You were the senior prepared, you were very disciplined, and today you are somewhere else. If they are listening to you right now, I mean, just give them something that would motivate them to aspire to become like you.
I think education is the key of progress, and I think all of us came a long way, and I think that just doing the right thing, motivation, keep doing what you're doing best, seek for advice, encouragement, and I think there's a lot that we can do, but I've gone through a lot, and I thank God for everything. I'm happy to be where I am today, and thanks to Grammar School Fontaine. I remember it wasn't easy, but we went through, everybody should expect the same thing. It's not always easy to have dinner on your plate and go to school every day as we did. So it's always a struggle. Everybody should do the same. Follow the rules, and it will take you to your final step.
Yeah, thank you so much for coming by. I know you are busy. I will let you go. Thank you again.
Thank you, Mr. Henry.
Yeah.
We got in diaspora, in America in particular, are strongly behind them, and we are together. We are one.
Thank you so much, and have a good time, sir.
You're welcome.
Yeah, many of you will know this gentleman here. He used to write the name for people to come on Saturday to clear. And at that time, we thought he was punishing, he was hatred. But looking at the work that you did in disciplining students, and look at where they are today, what can you say to those younger ones?
Well, I thank you so much for the batch 89-90. What you are doing is marvelous. At least we elders can copy from you guys. And I advise other batches not to compete with you guys, but to add what they can to support you, lead us to a greater GBHS for them.
Yeah, thank you so much, and thank you for coming out to support us this evening.
Thank you so much. You are doing a marvelous job.
Thanks.
God bless you.
Yeah. As you know, this is our financial secretary, Christantos Asso. He has been counting money upon counting in here with a contribution. How difficult and how challenging was it?
Mr. Director, I can tell you that it's very challenging. And I would want to give a very big thanks to the Boston brothers. They have done it, and they have done it big time. I don't know which other branch is going to be able to beat this, but they have set the bar so high that anybody attempting to host an occasion like this will surely be scared to even attempt it. So far, I think it's been great.
Yeah, I know you have been working all around the clock. You know, even when we're in the group, you are collecting money. Right here, you are still collecting money while people are drinking. And don't forget, I'm also here talking. I cannot hear anything. So we want to thank you so much, Chrysanthos, for doing the work that you are doing. I see that you are still counting money right here. Is that true?
It's very true, and it's always a pleasure. It's always good to serve and to serve the community. So we'll continue to do what we can do to make Gaza a number one. Gaza Media, we say thumbs up to you guys for the work that you are doing.
Thank you. This is Dr. Nkambele, who has put this together. And today, you took us to where we have never seen before. And we didn't have the opportunity to speak at that time when we were downtown Baltimore. How do you discover those historic sites?
I've been living here in Massachusetts for 15 years. So, of course, I know a few of the sites. And being that education is very important, and all these great guys were coming to town, it was just necessary for them to see this historic educational institution so that they would inspire themselves or their children to do something in the future. So that's why we went to those places.
Yes, and this occasion here, even though it's still going on, but for the people that I've spoken to, they say it's a huge success. It's not yet over. I mean, you are the person behind this thing. What can you, what energy, what, how do you make it to put this together?
Again, we are here, we are the Boston brothers, we are four of us, and then our wonderful wife we have, and it has gone on very well. It was not easy, but we said that God has been so nice to us. He has blessed us to be in America, in Canada. So why not have a day to enjoy ourselves and eat, walk on the red carpet, and just have fun. And I think we are having it.
Yeah, thank you, Julius. Thank you, Camille, Dr. Bella, for the wonderful work that you have done and bringing all the group together that have supported all the way they have done. Yeah, what do you want to say? I just want you to say something to those that are watching you right now in Cameroon.
We love you guys in Cameroon. You guys are wonderful. We know you are strong. We just, you know, I think we are brothers and sisters. Let's continue to form a united family. Gaza 89-90. Gaza, ahead, ahead, ahead.
Thank you, thank you.